Good morning to all. We are going to learn algebra and number theory. Its subject code is MA8551, lecture 2 under group theory. Course outcome: to introduce the groups, theorems and its applications using modular system, which will then be used to solve some related problems. And topic covered in this video: theorems on groups, modular system. We will see some applications of groups. It is mainly used in algebraic number theory and also in harmonic analysis. In harmonic analysis, we represent the functions or signals in a basic waves, and we also study the generalization of notations of Fourier series and Fourier transforms. And we use the diverse as a number theory and also representation of theory, signal processing, quantum mechanics, tidal analysis and also neuroscience. In all these branches we apply group theory. And it is also has application in music. In transformational theory, models musical transformations as an elements of mathematical group. Problem 3. The set of all fourth roots of unity 1, -1, i, -i is a group under usual multiplication. Solution: we have to prove that G is a group under usual multiplication. So we want to prove it is a group under usual multiplication. We know that I square equal to 1, and we have 1 into I equal to I. All these values we require in the Cayley table, so we calculate here. 1 into I equal to I, 1 into minus I, minus I, minus I into minus I, we get I square, which is equal to minus 1. I into minus I is equal to minus of I square, which is equal to 1. Since G is a finite set, we form Cayley table and verify the axioms. So this is a Cayley table under product 1 minus 1 I minus I. This side 1 minus 1 I minus I. We will take a product 1 into 1 1, 1 into minus 1 minus 1, 1 into I and 1 into minus I minus I. Similar way, we write all the values, the body of the table, or you can observe that the body of the elements, all the elements are nothing but which present in G, which existing in G. Now we have to prove that all four axioms are satisfied or not. We have to check closure property. The body of the Cayley table contains only elements of G, therefore closure axiom is satisfied. Associative property: associative axioms is inherited in G. We can also check the condition A into B into C is equal to A into B into C, where A comma B comma C contain in G. Identity element: from the table we have 1 into 1 is equal to 1, 1 into minus I is equal to minus I into 1 is equal to minus I, and 1 into I is equal to I into 1 is equal to I, 1 into minus I is equal to minus I into 1 is equal to minus I. Now you can observe that any element multiplied by 1, we get 1. We get the same element. 1 into I is equal to I. So 1 is the identity element. 1 into minus 1 minus I is equal to minus I. 1 is the identity element. So therefore we take 1 as the identity element in G. Inverse: we have to check the inverse axiom. 1 into 1 is equal to 1, therefore inverse of 1 is 1, and I into minus I is equal to 1, so the inverse of I is minus I, and inverse of I is minus 1, and minus 1 inverse is I. Similar way, 1 is the inverse of minus 1, therefore inverse axiom is satisfied, hence G comma star is a group. Then we can also check commutative property. We have A into B is equal to B into A for all A comma B belong to G. Therefore commutative axiom is also satisfied, hence G star is a abelian group. Example 4. Show that if every element in a group G is its own inverse, then G must be abelian. In another form we can write, in a group G, if A square equal to E for all A belongs to G, then G is abelian. So when you take A inverse
A inverse is A, then what you get? What is the property? A into A inverse is equal to E, inverse property. If I put A inverse as A, A into A, I will get A square equal to E. Then you want to prove that G is abelian. So solution, let A B belong to G, be any two elements, and A into B belongs to G. This is the closure property. Since given G is a group, closure property satisfies. So I have written A into B belong to G. Given every element is its own inverse. Therefore, A inverse is equal to A, and we take B inverse is equal to B. Now, already I said our closure property exists. So A into B, whole inverse is equal to A into B. This is A into B inverse is equal to A. So like that I have written. Now A into B whole inverse can be written as B inverse into A inverse, which is equal to A into B. Now B inverse is nothing but B, and A inverse is equal to A. So I get B into A is equal to A into B for all A comma B belongs to G. So this is the condition of abelian. It we proved, therefore G is abelian. Example 5. In a group G under binary operation multiplication, if A into B whole square is equal to A square into B square for all A comma B belong to G, then show that G under multiplication is abelian. Solution. Now we have to take A into B whole square is equal to A square into B square, and you have to prove that this is abelian. Abelian condition is A into B is equal to B into A. So we take the given formula, A into B whole square is equal to A square into B square. This can be written in product, A into B into A into B, and here A square can be written as A into A, B square can be written as B into B. Now by using the associative axiom, we can write A into B into A together into B, and here A into B together into B. Now by using left and right cancellation law, this A and A left cancellation law and B can be cancelled. So we get the only the middle term, B into A is equal to A into B. So I have written the condition. So hence we got the abelian formula, B into A is equal to A into B. This is true for all A comma B belong to G. Hence G star is abelian.
Modulo system. We define the addition modulo n by A plus modulo n B is equal to R, where R ranges from lies between 0 less than equal to R less than n. Here R is the remainder when A plus B is divided by n. Multiplication modulo n is A dot product n B is equal to R, where R lies between 0 and n. R is the remainder when A B is divided by n. For example, if n equal to 6, the set is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When you find the product 2, when you add 2 plus under mod 6, 5, 2 plus 5, which is equal to 7, that 7 is divided by 6, we get the remainder 1. So that should be your answer. And you check for a product 3. Dot product 6, 4 is equal to 0. How? 3 into 4 is equal to 12. When it is divided by 6, the remainder is 0. So that should be your answer. Show that the set G is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is a group under addition modulo 6. So the given elements are finite, and you want to prove that G under addition 6 is a group. We form a Cayley table. So the Cayley table is formed. 0 plus plus modulo 6 0 is equal to 0. So 1 plus modulo 6 0 1, and 2 like that. 2 modulo 6 0 is equal to 2. Same way you write all the elements, and 4 modulo 6 2, we get remainder 4 plus 2 is 6. It was given plus 6 modulo 6, so the remainder will be 0. So complete the table. We have to check for 4 axioms. The body of the table contains only elements of G once in each row and column. So G is closed under addition modulo 6. Associative also true under addition modulo 6. Identity element Z is 0 is the identity element in the Cayley table. So we get 0 plus 6 modulo addition modulo 6 1 is equal to 1 and 4 addition modulo 6 0 is equal to 4. So therefore this 0 is the identity element. Now we should find out the inverse. So the inverse of 0 is 0, inverse of 1 is 5, inverse of 2 is 4, inverse of 4 is 2 and inverse of 3 is 3. So keeping the identity element, you have to see the check the table and we should find out the inverse. So at last we have to check for A addition modulo 6, B is equal to B addition modulo 6 is equal to A. Therefore, in the table, you can see the elements formed in the main diagonal are the same. So G is commutative under addition 6. Therefore, G addition modulo 6 is an abelian group. And you can also prove that G is equal to set of all 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n minus 1 is also a group under addition modulo 6. Thank you students, we have seen some theorems on groups and also the modular system problems.